Hey everyone, Shaybear 1000 here. Just waiting on this storm to come. It shouldn't be here till tomorrow, but let's go outside. There's a little bit of thunder going on. I'll let you know what's happening. Okay guys, it's starting to thunder. It's about 5:30. This is Monday night. Now, we are under a hurricane warning in our county, but the weird thing is we got a notification saying that our warning was extended until 1 a.m. tomorrow morning, tonight, late tonight, whatever. But the hurricane ain't even supposed to hit until tomorrow night, so that doesn't make sense why they do that. I don't know if you can hear that. It's thundering. I'm waiting on it to start raining any time. So tomorrow, I'm gonna move the Corvette over here because I don't trust that palm tree. And there's a branch there I don't trust, so I'll probably put the Corvette right in here and the truck right about here. Just to keep them away from that palm tree. Got some batteries fully charged. They're just on trickle charge now. And then of course we got the battery in here if we need it. And that's got 8 6-volt batteries, so if I need the inverter, I can still hook it up 12 volt, just hook it up to 2 of the 6 volts at a time, and that'd be 4 times. I can do that, and then we'll have the truck. But we got the generator. I brought it out yesterday and fired it up. First pull, I got to get a battery for it. It's battery's no good no more. It just takes one of those little batteries. Because it's got electric start, but man, that thing's so easy to pull. One pull, it'll start every time. And it is plumb full of gas, so we should get some propane because it'll run on propane or gasoline. It's dual fuel, so that's cool. We should get a tank of propane because we don't use our grill anymore. We got 2 tanks back there. They're empty, but so we should get them filled just to have for the generator. So I got it sitting here at the back of the garage right there, so I can pull it out if we need it. But the inverter, the battery power is going to be for us to run the computer, TV, and internet. So that way, you know, we still got some kind of entertainment. The generator will be running the refrigerator, air conditioner, and microwave. It is big enough, 7,500 watt peak power. It will run a whole house. They used to run it in their house when their power would go out. They ran 2 refrigerators, the pool, the pump filter stuff for the pool, their central air conditioner, microwave, lights, TVs. They used to run the whole house with it. I just need to get me a plug so I can run the whole house. But in the meantime, I got that little thing up there on the wall that runs the power in the kitchen. So Monkey ran down to the store to get Bruno some food. Well, he's got food. He's got dry food, but she says I spoil him. But she had to go get him some moist food. She buys him little moist doggy. I think it's called Caesar's. They're in a little container. They're wet food, and she gets him deer and all kinds of different flavors. Now that's for his breakfast. He has to have his breakfast every morning. That's what he has for breakfast. So, yeah. But it's booming over there about northwest. Oh, actually, that's almost west. That's coming from about Crystal River area, and they're supposed to get hit hard, and we're only 18 minutes drive from Crystal River. So when they get hit, we get hit. But right here, it's not so bad because we're on just about 3/4 of the way up of a hill. I know it don't look like it, but that's like a 15% grade or something. And and then we got all these trees. So like when we had Hurricane Irma, it was blowing pretty good here. I mean, trees and stuff was blowing. I mean, you could feel it, but as soon as, and I walked up there, as soon as I got to the very tippity top, like the next house over, as soon as I got to the top of the hill, man, it about blew me over. It was weird because, like, right here, we had nothing. We had some palm fronds down and stuff like that, some tree branches, some of this, you know, some Spanish moss from the trees and stuff. But as soon as you go up to the top of the hill, I mean, it was like devastation. There was trees down and sheds blown over and trash cans blown all over the place. And it was bad right on top of the hill. But this tree doesn't really worry me too much. But we do need to get it taken down because it kind of bends over this way towards the house. I mean, the house already needs a roof, but we don't need that coming down on it. You know, that's like $600, the cheapest we could get somebody to come in and take it down because they got to get a bucket. They don't climb like they used to, man. We used to get climbing gear and climb up them trees. Now they bring buckets in. If they don't have a bucket truck, they won't do it. That tree there that's bent like that, bent way over, if that comes down, it won't hit anything. Maybe the table in the backyard, but it won't hit anything if it comes down. So neither will that one. That one won't hurt anything. It's just this one, depending on which way it goes. If it goes anywhere, I hope it goes that way. I mean, it may take this power line out, but you know, I don't want it coming down and on the vet and then that branch there where the top of it fell. Ooh, lightning. Top of it fell out one time and landed in the back of the truck and flipped out of the truck and came over, landed back of the truck, flipped out of the truck and hit the Chrysler. It dented the roof frame, it bent the roof frame, took out the side glass and smashed in the door. If it wasn't for that, I would have put a new engine in it, but geez, now I wouldn't. I mean, you know, nope. I was like, we're done junking. I'm calling a junk guy, come get it. So I'll keep you guys posted. I don't know why it's so foggy and might be my lens. I don't know. I'll check my lens. But yeah, that's what's happening. So I'll keep you guys posted on what's going on. I don't think anything big will be going on till tomorrow, but I'll keep you informed. All right, guys, so I've got plenty of water stored. We've got bottled water. I've got two big pots of water I filtered. We got plenty of food. So, yeah, we should be good to go. Everything should be all right. I'm trying to think. That's pretty much it. So, as the storm progresses, I'll keep you guys posted on what's going on. So that's going to be it for right now. I'll talk to you guys soon. Shea Bear, the Myth, the Man, the Legend, gone for now. Stay safe, everyone. We'll see you soon. Bye-bye.